Today, we are going to talk about how to lose weight when you have diabetes. I see a lot of diabetic patients and I get this question every day. How am I going to lose weight because of diabetes? Am I stuck with this weight gain? No, tune in. I'm gonna give you all the secrets. Okay, so number one question, why do you gain weight when you have diabetes? Well, that is very, very common. Number one, when you're insulin resistant, if you have type 2 diabetes and you're insulin resistant, it is so freaking easy to gain weight. So I never blame my patients. Look, it is not you. It is sometimes the body you came in, the genetics, a lot of environmental factors contribute to your weight gain. So first of all, let's take the blame part away. Now, of course, we have to make sure that we concentrate on your diet and exercise, and that's not easy. And the medications play a huge role as well, but we'll talk about which medications that causes weight gain that you didn't know about, and then which medications that can actually cause tremendous weight loss that you have never heard of. So, let's go step by step. So, the lifestyle changes. We always preach patients, okay, go lose weight, eat better, blah, 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 right? How many people change their behavior? Very little. I mean, it is hard, okay? Especially when you're 40, 50 year old, you have lived your life, and now somebody comes and tells you, oh, you gotta change everything. First of all, that's not realistic. We have to make sure that we set realistic expectations, and then that depends on every individual patient. And guess what? Even if I tell you right now, you feel super pumped up, you feel like super ready to go lose weight, you're gonna, in a day or two, you're gonna go into a party, somebody's gonna invite you somewhere, somebody's gonna put a plate in front of you, bam, everything is gone. So it is very important to feel accountable. So how do you feel accountable? You have to be monitored. Okay, so if a police is monitoring you everywhere, okay, how careful would you be with your behavior? I'm not saying that you're a criminal, but even when you're going, you know, on a road which is 30 miles an hour, most people go 35. But if you know that the police is behind you, would you go 35? You'd probably stick with 30, right? So being monitored is extremely important. So that's why at Sugar MDs, we monitor you. We monitor your blood sugars. Every time you enter, it automatically comes to us. Everything you eat, if you want to log that in, it comes to us. So as long as you feel accountable, that is the key. So at sugarmds.com, we help you with that. Now, let's move on. What medications can actually help you lose weight? But before that, let's touch base. What are you on right now? Look at your medication list. If you're on a glipizide, glimepiride, glyburide, or any sort of insulin, you're not in a good position. You will probably continue to gain weight. No matter what you do, it is hard. And the moment you start going on a diet and you really force yourself, you may end up with a very severe low blood sugar, and you do not want that. When you have a low blood sugar, you feel like a truck passed right on top of you. So it's not a good feeling. So how do we tease that out? In my practice, I always try to get rid of these medications that causes weight gain and all the insulins. If I can get rid of insulin, I will, and I can. And there are a lot of ways to do that. It's just not easy in a primary care setting. That's why in my specialty practice at sugarmds.com, we always strive to get people off of medications that causes weight gain and all the insulins if possible. And that is possible. Most people think that once they go on an insulin, they're insulin dependent. No, that's a no. You never become insulin dependent unless you're type 1 diabetic, okay? So let's go back to the medications you're on. So if you're on glipizide, glimepiride, we talked about the glyburide, or any insulin. It could be Tresiba, it could be Toujeo, Lantus, Levemir, Novolog, Humalog, Novolin, Humulin, you name it. So how do we get rid of these medications? Number one, of course, we're gonna work on your lifestyle changes and exercise, as that has a dramatic effect. Every time you make a change in your diet and every time you make a change in exercise, that is like equal to one medication. Now, set that aside, what can we do for your current medications? Number one, there are a lot of medications in the market that can actually, that we can replace with. As a result, you suddenly stop gaining weight and immediately go into weight loss mode. So how does that happen? Now, there are two classes of agents in the market. Number one is a GLP-1 agonist, and the number two is SGLT2 inhibitors. Now, not everybody is a great candidate for it. So after listening to this video, don't just go to your doctor and say, oh, give me this, give me that. First of all, doctors don't like that. And number two, your doctor may not be comfortable with it. The best medication in the market right now, best medications I would say, because I'm not siding with any medications or any company or brand, Ozempic is number one in weight loss. And then Trulicity is there as well. And then you have Victoza, you have Bydureon. All these agents help tremendously. And we'll talk about how do they help. And these are called GLP-1 class. They are intestinal hormone agonists. So why intestinal hormones are so important, we'll touch base in a second. And the second part is SGLT2 inhibitors. These are the medications that allow your kidney to excrete excessive sugar in your system. And these are called Invokana, Jardiance, Farxiga, Steglatro. Okay, so again, let's go back to how they work and why they're important. Now, when you have diabetes, your gastrointestinal system unfortunately does not produce enough gastrointestinal hormone. So, as you know, your body communicates, the different organs communicate through hormones. That's the only communication system. So when you eat normally, your stomach and your intestinal system is supposed to make an intestinal hormone to alert your pancreas, which is the insulin producing organ, to make enough insulin. Now in diabetes, that's not really happening efficiently. So as a result, we give these medications and suddenly your body makes the insulin within you. And as a result, you do not have to take insulin. So insulin is only given only as much as you need, right? And that takes care of the blood sugar that comes with the food. Now, how do you really lose weight if your body is making insulin? I just told you that insulin causes weight gain, right? So here is the difference. When your body makes only enough insulin to take care of what you eat, then that's not a big problem. On the other hand, if you are taking insulin from outside, you are eating to compensate for the insulin that you have already taken. So you have to eat enough to avoid a low blood sugar because you are giving a predetermined amount of insulin and you're almost forced to eat. On the other hand, the human body, we don't always eat a big meal. We sometimes have a small lunch, sometimes a big lunch, and you know, most of the time small dinner, but sometimes big dinner, whatever. And our body normally adjusts that insulin. And unfortunately, when you're on insulin, you're given a fixed amount of insulin, you know, unless you're counting carbs, which most of the time it's hard to do, you end up getting too much insulin in your system, which causes weight gain. Now, the second good thing about these medications, they cut your appetite. So we have a lot of intestinal hormone receptors in our body, and some of them are in the hypothalamus, which is where the appetite center is. So when you take these medications, you know, or even before in the normal people, when we eat, that these hormones go to your brain, says there's food, okay, stop eating. Simple as that. Now, when that's not really working, we are replacing these intestinal hormones so your body actually realizes that there is food. So when I typically start these medications, people basically, you know, they just feel full by half the plate or half the hamburger or whatever, everything goes in half and they feel full. Now, another good thing about these medications, that's the third good thing about these medications, is that it slows down your intestinal system. So normally you eat things and then it goes through right away. Now, but if it stays in your system, if it stays in your stomach, instead of 2 hours, it stays in your stomach for 6 hours. That means that for 6 hours you have a full stomach. And that means that you're not gonna feel hungry. So those are all the good things that causes weight loss. Again, these medications are Ozempic, Trulicity, Victoza, Bydureon. Byetta was there, but this is too cumbersome, it's too old to use. But if you have to use Byetta, we can use Byetta as well. But again, the most popular ones nowadays are Ozempic and Trulicity. And they're once a week, and they do the wonders. Okay, so the next class of agents are SGLT2 inhibitors, and as we discussed, these are Jardiance, Steglatro, Invokana, and Farxiga. Now, these agents basically they allow your kidney to excrete blood sugar. So normally your kidneys do not want to let the sugars go. Okay, so normally our body tries to save everything. So if you're in a very food deprived area, you don't want to lose anything, right? So our body is designed to save everything. So your kidney will not let sugar go unless you're 220 or 250 in blood sugars, which is too high to begin with. So that's why you will lose weight. If your blood sugars are running 300, 400 all the time, you may lose weight just because your blood sugars are running so high and kidney will start spilling it out after 250. So just because you're losing weight without medications and you have diabetes, that's not a good thing. We call that a wasting because, you know, your body is losing so much sugar, you end up, destroying all your protein and fat as well. However, with these medications in a controllable fashion, when your blood sugars are going about 100, in normal circumstances, you wouldn't urinate that blood sugar. However, on these medications, you know, let's say I brought your blood sugar down to 200, but then you need a little bit more effort to bring the blood sugars down. Now, we can put insulin on and bring your blood sugar down, but then the insulin packs the glucose into fat cells and causes weight gain. On the other hand, we can actually give you these medications, and then what happens mechanically is that this blood sugar is filtered through the kidneys and are not reabsorbed. As a result, you pass all the sugar into the toilet. So you can lose 300 calories almost every day. So that's a lot of calories. So a lot of people, for example, overestimate actually their how much exercise they do. They go to the gym and they walk like half an hour for an hour. They just walk. It's not like running or sprinting, and they think that they have lost 500 calories. That's not true. They're probably losing 100, 150 calories. And if they're losing 300 calories an hour, they're doing pretty good. Now think about this, these medications are making you lose 300 calories just by going to the restroom. Now of course you need to be drinking more water because the sugar is going to absorb your water as well, so you're going to be going to the restroom more often, so you need to stay hydrated. These agents have been shown to reduce the heart failure and heart attacks as well. They also have been shown to reduce the progression of diabetic kidney disease. Okay, so these are the ways to, again, to lose weight. Diet and exercise is very important. Being accountable is very important. Have a wonderful day.